So I'm from Maui, and so like the opportunity to go down there is incredible, but also yeah, really cold compared to here. It was really amazing. I think there's nothing like Antarctica.
And we were working with a group called the sea spiders or the Pycnogonids, which occur in Hawaii, but they're very small. They're found all over the world, and in the Antarctic they reach extremely large sizes. They're all leg, so they have a very small body and a very short gut in their body. And then their gut goes out to the tip of all of their legs. So they do most of their digestion and food processing in their legs. They also have their gonads in their legs. So when they're developing eggs or sperm, they do it in their legs. But he also noticed that these peristaltic movements of the gut, which we'd known about for many, many years, but we thought were just part of the digestive process, were actually moving the blood around much like a pump, much like a heart would. It was a really fortuitous discovery of a completely new way that animals do things.
It's just like a new way of thinking about how oxygen can be delivered within a body system.
I think it's just kind of an aha moment or a gee whiz moment where you suddenly realize that what you think guts are for digestion and hearts and blood vessels are for moving oxygen around. And here you find an animal that does it in a completely different and unexpected way.
It's a new way of thinking of things. Because it's a new way of like the oxygen delivery, we want to know now whether like other species or even just the other taxa can also do this.